Hello guys, my name is Bob. In this video, I am going to show you how to find the Maclaurin series of eta power signs using the top right hand corners formula. So the top right hand corners formula tells us that a function can be expressed as an infinite series called the Maclaurin series, in which each term can be expressed as the following formula. Before I review the solution, do help me to press the subscribe button for more integration problems and Maclaurin series problems. And if you guys do like this solution, press the thumbs up icon. And I shall now begin revealing the Maclaurin series of e to the power sine x. And I'm going to do it up to the x to the power 4 terms. So first off, we have to find what is the function evaluated at x is equal to 0. The function differentiated one time and evaluated at x is equal to 0. The function evaluated two times and evaluated at x is equal to 0. The function differentiated three times and evaluated at x is equal to 0. The function differentiated four times and evaluated at x is equal to 0. So now we let the function of x be equals to e to the power of sine x. And we differentiate the function one time, we will get cosine x e to the power of sine x, in which this is also the same as cosine x fx, because my e to the power of sine x is fx. We now find the function differentiated two times. How are we going to do it? We are using the product rule of differentiation. So we have cosine x differentiate with respect to x of fx plus fx differentiate with respect to x of cosine x. So this is equals to cosine x f1x plus fx negative sine x. To find next will be the f3x, which means differentiating the function three times. We have to do the product rule of differentiation on both of the terms in f2x. So what we have is we have cosine x differentiate with respect to x of f1x plus f1x differentiate with respect to x of cosine x plus differentiate with respect to x of negative sine x times fx plus negative sine x differentiate with respect to x of fx. And then we can proceed to evaluate. So we have cosine x, the first term, differentiate with respect to x of f1x, f2x plus f1x differentiate with respect to x of cosine x is negative sine x plus fx differentiate with respect to x of negative sine x is negative cosine x plus negative sine x differentiate with respect to x of fx is f1x. So this third term, fx negative cosine x, okay, we can substitute it as negative f1x, okay, because my f1x is cosine x fx. And negative cosine x fx is equals to negative f1x. So now, after which you can evaluate what is my function differentiated four times. This time round, we have to do quite a bit of product rule of differentiation for three of the terms, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so that will be first term, cosine x differentiate with respect to x of f2x times plus f2x differentiate with respect to x of cosine x. For the second term, we have f1x differentiate with respect to x of negative sine x plus negative sine x differentiate with respect to x of f1x, okay, plus differentiate with respect to x of negative f1x. Last but not least, we have negative sine x differentiate with respect to x of f1x plus f1x differentiate with respect to x of negative sine x. Okay, and then we can proceed to evaluate the following. So we have cosine x f3x plus f2x negative sine x plus f1x negative cosine x plus negative sine x f2x plus differentiation, we expect the x of negative f1x is negative f2x, and then we have negative sine x differentiate, we expect the x of f1x is f2x, and then f1x differentiate, we expect the x of negative sine x is negative cosine x. I will stop until this point, and then now we find out, okay, all the functions evaluate that x is equal to 0. So for f0, it's equal to e to the power of sine 0, which is e to the power of 0, because sine 0 is 0, so hence we have e to the power of 0 is equal to 1. F10 is equivalent to cosine 0 f0. Cosine 0 is 1, f0 is 1, as evaluated just now, so 1 times 1 is 1. F20 is equal to cosine 0 f10. So we know cosine 0 f10 is basically 1. Plus fx times negative sine 0. So negative sine 0 is 0. So the second term basically is just 0. Okay, so second term 0. Okay, second term is 0, so we only have 1. F30 is equal to the following, okay? So we need to ignore the second and the fourth term, because if I were to substitute x equals to 0 into sine, it will give 0. So we focus on the cosine x f2x minus f1x. Cosine 0 f20 is 1 minus away f10. So it's equals to 1 minus 1 is basically 0. So f30 is 0. And f40, let's review f40. F40, first thing we need to do is we can ignore the terms containing sine x, okay, because sine 0 is 0. And then we just need to focus on the remaining, and also we can also ignore the term in which has f30 or f3x, because when x is equal to 0, f3 0. So we only need to focus on these three terms, 1, 2, and 3. So basically, after you evaluate it, you should be able to get negative 3, because this term is negative 1, this term is negative 1, this term is negative 1. My f40 is negative 3. So now, once we have evaluated our function at x equals to 0, we can actually find out what is the Maclaurin series of e to the power of sine x up to the x to the power of 4 term. So the Maclaurin series of e to the power of sine x can be approximated as the following. F0 is 1 plus F10 is 1 times x, okay, over 1 factorial, plus for the third term, x squared, f20 is 1 over 2 factorial, plus f30 is 0, so fourth term, there is no fourth term. For the fifth term, it's just basically negative 3 times x to the power of 4 over 4 factorial. Alright, so this is equivalent to 1 plus x plus x squared over 2 factorial, and then we have subtracting away x to the power of 4 over 8. Alright, and this is the Maclaurin series up to the x to the power of 4 terms of e to the power of sine x. If you guys do like this solution, press the like button. Don't forget to help me, okay, if you liked integration Maclaurin series, subscribe to this channel. Thank you for your support. My name is Bob. I will see you in the next video.